morning, everyone. We begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you. My brothers and sisters, as we join together today, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. Came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, increase our faith, hope, and charity, and make us love what you command, so that we may merit what you promise. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, be subordinate to one another out of reverence for Christ. Wives should be subordinate to their husbands. No, that's Tuesday. Today is Wednesday. I heard that yesterday. Okay. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. Honor your father and your mother. This is the first commandment with a promise, that it may go well with you, and that you may have a long life on earth. Fathers, do not provoke your children to anger, but bring them up with the training and instruction of the Lord. Slaves, be obedient to your human masters with fear and trembling, in sincerity of heart, as to Christ. Not only when being watched or currying favor, but as slaves of Christ, doing the will of God from the heart, willingly serving the Lord and not men, knowing that each will be requited from the Lord. And for whatever good he does, whether he is slave or free, masters, act in the same way towards them and stop bullying, knowing that both they and you have a master in heaven and that with him there is no partiality. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The Lord is faithful in all his works. Words. Faithful in all his words. Let all your works give you thanks, O Lord, and let your faithful ones bless you, and let them discourse of the glory of your kingdom and speak of your might. The Lord is faithful in all his words, making known to men their might and the glorious splendor of your kingdom. Your kingdom is a kingdom for all ages, and your dominion endures through all generations. The Lord is faithful in all his words. The Lord is faithful in all his words and holy in all his works. The Lord lifts up all who are falling and raises up all who are bowed down. The Lord is faithful in all his words.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
has called us through the gospel to possess the glory of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus passed through towns and villages, teaching as he went and making his way to Jerusalem. Someone asked him, "Lord, will only a few people be saved?" He answered them, "Strive to enter through the narrow gate, for many, I tell you, will attempt to enter, but will not be strong enough. After the master of the house has arisen and locked the door, and then you will stand outside knocking and say, 'Lord, open the door for us.' He will say to you in reply, 'I do not know where you are from.' And you will say, 'We ate and drank in your company, and you taught in our streets.' Then he will say to you, 'I do not know where you are from. Depart from me, all you evildoers.' And there will be wailing and grinding of teeth when you see Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, and all the prophets of the kingdom of God, and you yourselves cast out. And people will come from the east and the west, and from the north and the south, and will recline at the table in the kingdom of God. For behold, some who are last who will be first, and some are first who will be last." The Gospel of the Lord. So as we listen to that gospel passage, you get a little nervous at all? Because our Lord doesn't exactly refute the question when, are only a few going to be saved? And he kind of doesn't exactly skirt it. He's like, yeah, many are going to try this, but they're not going to be able to do it. And all of a sudden you're going, But I would also point out something very, very simple here. Something that I think is the key to unlocking all of this. Many will try, will be not strong enough. What does that imply? It implies, dear friends, that we're trying to do it all on our own, which last I checked is that primordial sin that begins with P and ends with ride. Some of you are looking at it a little curiously at me. That's pride for 200 points in the lead, right? Pride, yes. The one that is an ungodly self-reliance that says I can do it all on my own. That's why if you think you're going to be strong enough to power through this and just be like, I'm going to handle business, take care of it. Well, no. No, we're not. Because again, the Lord speaks elsewhere of things that are going to be extremely hard. Remember when he says to the apostles, hey, you know what? It's easier for a camel to pass through the eye of a needle than the rich man to enter heaven? Ooh, problems. The idea, dear friends, is that none of us are going to be able to do this by ourselves. We are going to be led and transformed by the goodness of God working within to allow this to occur. It is not going to be us and our ungodly self-reliance that are going to get there. It is going to be our humility before God and letting him work in here. And here's the beautiful part. He does. Can and he will. It's just sometimes we need to kind of get past what I call the gatekeeper up here and bypass into the heart itself. Because up here we make so many things and excuses trying to kind of engineer things according to our own will. Whereas the Lord just says, will you trust me? Will you turn your heart to me? Will you allow me to do what I desire to help you to enter into this deep? I think, my friends, when we look at that gospel passage, there's nothing to fear if we realize that it's not about our strength and our power and our ability to get us there, but it's about placing ourselves in those holy hands of God, perhaps in that light of St. Therese that says, I need to be scooped up into the arms of God as opposed to me trying to power my way through this. She herself said, I need an elevator to God. And if that's the case, what's that elevator? It's humility and recognition that I have to be childlike, not childish. We understand the difference, right? You ever seen childish? Holding your breath, stomping your feet, kind of a little bit of tears. None of you have ever encountered this at all, right? Childlike. You ever seen like a little one like kind of pop up, maybe grab your leg and you have to scoop them up into your arms? Imagine now you're a beloved son or daughter of God. Rather, don't imagine, because you are. And maybe tug at the leg of our Lord and allow him to lift you up. That's going to be our way to the heavenly kingdom. So let us entrust ourselves over to that care of God, may see him face to face and enter into the fullness of our heavenly joy. Trusting in our Lord and Savior, let us lift our prayers before him this day, that the joys and griefs of all the world might be the joys and griefs of the followers of Christ. We pray to the Lord. That each day the church might scrutinize the signs of the times and interpret them in the light of the gospel. We pray to the Lord. That leaders of nations will ensure the dignity of all their people. We pray to the Lord. That love of God and love of neighbor come to guide our choices in living, we pray to the Lord. That those who are sick and suffering in any way may find relief in the mercy of Christ, we pray to the Lord. That those who have died find rejoicing at the heavenly banquet in the kingdom of God, we pray to the Lord. As we lift up Alexander and Rita Jolie in the prayer of this liturgy, let's also offer up our prayers to the Lord in the silence of our own hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Merciful Savior, invigorate our hearts with your merciful love, that we may draw close to you in all things and enter into your heavenly kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
With humble spirit and contrite heart, may we accept by your Lord your sacrifice. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Look, we pray, O Lord, on the offerings we make to your majesty, that whatever is done by us in your service may be directed above all to your glory. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with
you. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, creator of the world and source of all life, for you never forsake the works of your wisdom, but by your providence are even now at work in our midst. With mighty hand and outstretched arm, you led your people Israel through the desert. Now, as your church makes her pilgrim journey in the world, you always accompany her by the power of the Holy Spirit and lead her along the path of time to the eternal joy of your kingdom through Christ our Lord. And so with angels and saints, we too sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy and to be glorified, O God. Love the human race who always walk with us in the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son, present in our midst, when we are gathered by his love. And when, as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that, by the power of the Spirit of your love, you may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. And so, having called us to your table, Lord, confirm us in unity, so that together with Francis our Pope and Robert our Bishop, with all bishops, priests, and deacons, and your entire people, as we walk your ways with faith and hope, we may strive to bring joy and trust into the world. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever, there in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and martyrs, with Saint Patrick, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, Thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Let's offer to one another a sign of peace.
Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, dona nobis pace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. communion antiphon, we will ring out our joy at your saving help and exalt in the name of our God. Now pray the prayer of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there. Unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. May your sacraments, O Lord, we pray, perfect in us what lies within them, that what we now celebrate in signs, we may one day possess in truth. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Friends, just a reminder that we have again All Saints Day on Friday, which is a holy day of obligation. So we'll have masses at 8 a.m. and 7 p.m. in the church. And then Saturday, because an All Souls Mass does need to be said because it's a Mass for All Souls, we will have an 8 a.m. Mass that day for All Souls on Saturday morning. So, if you'd like to come to any of them, well, Friday you have to come too, whether you do it here or anywhere. But again, Saturday, if you'd like to join us for that one, we certainly invite you for that, as it again is a beautiful celebration for all the souls that we lift up in prayer. St. Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, Cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The fourth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Great day, everyone.